And when it rains, those chemicals are carried into the rivers, and the rivers are polluted. The fishes die. Other creatures in the waters die. And those which survive, they carry those chemicals in their bodies. And when you buy the fish, it doesn't taste good like it used to be in those days, when nature was at its best. When you eat those fishes or those whatever you eat, you are taking in some poisons. And today we have cancers. Cancer of the breast. Cancer of the nose. Cancer of the foot. And what cancer do you have? All kinds of cancers which we never used. When we pollute the environment, we commit suicide. The environment is very important. Your good health depends on the environment within which you are. Some countries have spoiled their environment, and they cannot reverse it. But in Africa we are blessed, because we do have our environment still natural today. Let's keep it that way. Let's keep it healthy. Healthy environment means healthy people. Hallelujah. Some of the sicknesses we are suffering from are a consequence of being unjust to our environment. So the time has come. The time has come. Time of jubilee. Let us release the land. Let us keep our environment clean. Healthy environment means healthy people. And you pastors must apply yourself to ecological theology. A theology that talks about the environment. Ecological theology will have healthy church members, and they will live in the environment that is clean and healthy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's our stewardship. We need to preach environmental justice. We need to preach ecological theology that gives hope to the world, so that we don't destroy our house. Our house. The world is our habitat. Am I speaking above your head? Am I speaking above your head? This is the truth we need to hear. Those of you who have your homes, do you allow anybody to do anything in your house? To come in and break the windows? Break the tables? Do all that they want? Do you allow them to do that? In your house? But what are we doing today? We are pulling apart our environment, our ecosystem. We are pulling apart everything. And some of these cars you are driving are simply trash being thrown into our country, because there are no places to throw them in their country. And you know, some of your vehicles cannot get rotten. Where are you going to take them? They are chemically made. And they cannot reverse it. They cannot break those molecules apart. It is dangerous. We are living dangerously. Things that are coming into our environment are deadly. Africa has become a dumping ground.
Africa
for chemical waste. Medicines. Whatever they want to throw, they throw at you. God have mercy this
Jubilee.
Somebody must get up and speak up. Umupushi tasala.
A beggar does not choose.
That's why we should not be beggars. It is a shame that we have become beggars. When God has given us riches and resources in our country, have mercy, O God. Every country in the world knows that the only hope for the world is Africa. Africa is the hope of the world. We have China in Africa. We have America in Africa. We have Britons in Africa.
British in Africa.
Call them, they are coming to Africa to do business with
us.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
How do we keep this land which God has given us? We need to be responsible citizens. We need to be hardworking. Hallelujah. Laziness will cause other people to exploit us. How is it that we have foreigners in good shops? And we have our young people on the street. Empowered. To put up anything anywhere. How is it that foreigners are inside and I'm outside? In my own country. Let's stop being lazy. Be hardworking. In Jubilee. Supporting one another. It is becoming hard to do business because each one for himself and God for us all. I told you some time back that as I was walking, I heard a certain drunken person. He was talking to himself. You know, drunkards are full of stuff. They speak all the way from bar up to their home. And the proverb says, "Tabunwa mwipi ni shalepa."
A short man will not drink, he will become tall.
And this man was talking. He said, "You see, he was calling the Indians. They care for one another. They help each other. Someone can come today poor, walking in sandals, Indian,